slash control seat of your choice. Find your lower body growing heavy, maybe pushing down or using your thighs something to assist yourself. And finding your spine growing long, extending beyond your body, extending out of your crown. Taking a deep breath here in through the mouth and out through the mouth. In through the nose, out through the mouth. One more time, in through the nose. Take a little bit more in and retain. Hips here. Focus your attention on your third eye, on its nose, and move it side to side. Beautiful. Inhale, hold. Our knees go wide or they come in. Our back will let us know which it prefers. And once you find which you prefer, letting your sits bones sink as close to your toes as possible, following your fingers out, melting your forehead and your chest and heart. Beginning to get in touch with your mat, your space around you, with your breath. Please raise your right hand now if you'd like to opt out of any touch, any massage, or any adjustments. Please raise your left hand if you'd like to opt out of any aromatherapy, essential oil, or mind-body. Thank you. Thank you. bringing our weight forward, coming into our first tabletop position. Slowly moving, almost as if you're a sloth today. Placing each body part intentionally, hands on your shoulders, fingers spread wide, knees under hips. Pushing into the tops of our feet, maybe letting our knees hover, taking weight off our knees. And hovering for 5, 4, feel your tailbone extend out towards the back of the room and your crown extend towards the front. 2, 1, and slowly welcome down. Inhale, dropping the belly, letting the heart shine forward. Exhale, curling the tailbone first, lifting the spine, chin to chest. Inhale, continue here at your own pace, beginning to match your body with movement. Maybe closing your eyes, letting the mind intelligence drop into the body intelligence. Marrying your breath, your life source, your chi with your body. And finding any freedom within structure here. So maybe twirling your hips. Getting little signals from your body of what it wants to kind of work out. So maybe pull your neck a little bit and your shoulders. I invite you today to, at any point, if you look around, to not look around for comparison, but look around for inspiration. Beautiful. One more cat cow here. Inhale, dropping the tummy. Exhale, lifting the navel to the spine. Inhale, coming to neutral. Inhale, right hand up towards the sky. Exhale, threading through. Letting the right ear hit the mat. Maybe crawling out the left fingertips all the way to the front of the room or behind your back. Inhale here. Exhale, relax everything in the shoulders. Crawling that left hand in front of the face again. Inhale, right hand up to the sky. Exhale, lower it down. Inhale. Left hand up for the sky. Breathe. Exhale, breath. You can maybe round it down the other side, calling the right hand maybe up in front or behind your back into the left hip. Inhale here. Exhale, relax, surrender. Placing the right hand in front of our face. Inhale, left hand up for the sky. Exhale, put it down. Curling our toes under and sending our hips up as slowly as possible. Really sending those hip bones as high up into the sky as possible. Keeping our knees generously bent. Going through our checklist, are our fingers spread as wide as possible? Or our shoulders are staying down or back? Are we tucking our lower ribcage in and our knee bent? Are our knees bent? Are our feet together or connected? Really pressing into the thumb and the pointer finger. Taking a moment here, maybe looking up for what's the hip going on here, so leaving to our plank. And exhaling back, reversing the wave right down. So we'll do a few of those. Inhale, wave forward. Exhale. Inhale, wave forward. Exhale. Now we're taking off. Two more of those. Let your neighbor hear your breath. Moving down dog, inhale to side here. Let it go. right below our knee, or our knee to be slightly behind our ankle. Roll the shoulders, inhale, okay. Stepping the back foot to meet the front. Inhale, happy lift. Extend the crown. Exhale, forward fold. Letting it go here, grabbing elbows. Finding strength in your lower body and finding flexibility in your upper body. Releasing the arms. There's two options here. Either we can walk our arms all the way to the right and peek beyond our right, our left armpit. And just finding some exploration here. So maybe you go beyond the point, maybe you come back. When you feel ready, switching to the other side. Keeping your knees slightly bent here. Releasing the neck, letting the head really weigh down. Do not hold your head. Coming back to center. Inhale, happy lift. Exhale, forward fold. Sweeping the arms along the mat. Inhale all the way up towards the sky. Exhale, hands up heart center. Closing the eyes, taking three breaths here. Bring that attention back to the mind. And if you don't have an intention, maybe just taking one that sounds familiar. Acceptance, gratitude, presence. Beautiful. Inhale, bare hands up to the sky. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, happy lift. Exhale, step it back. Holding plank here, tucking those elbows in towards the body and lowering all the way down onto our front. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, lower. Three more of those, really pulling the elbows and the shoulders back. Exhale, lowering. Catching a wave. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, lower. And pushing up, inhale, plank. Exhale, lower. Inhale to side. Inhale for lion's breath, sticking your tongue out of your mouth. One more of those, really forcing the feet out of your body. Inhale, left foot up on the chest. Holding it there, playing around, exploring, seeing how to bend your right leg and your left leg. Exhale, knee to chin, and pivot. Inhale, loop the shoulders. Exhale, step the back foot to the front. Inhale, happy lift. Exhale, lower fold. Bending the left leg, straining the right. Placing the left hand in front of both feet. Inhale, right hand up towards the sky. Exhale. Inhale, lift the right hand a little bit higher, pushing into both feet. Exhale, fold it back down. Switching legs, bending the right leg this time, straightening left, placing the right hand on left foot. Inhale, left hand up for the sky. Exhale here. Inhale, lift a little bit higher, push into both feet. Exhale, lower. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, lower. Inhale, hands all the way up to the side. Maybe taking a slight back bend here. there tucking the tailbone in to protect your lower back and just trying to bend the upper back. Ever so slightly, looking up at the sun, and exhaling at the heart center. Closing eyes. Listening to your breath, finding stillness. Feeling your toes on the ground, feeling your structure here. Placing most of the weight into your heels. Maybe the knees move isometrically outward to ground yourself in, or if you prefer, your thighs moving in towards the back of the leg. Tucking the tailbone, bringing the navel to the spine, hugging in the lower ribs. Shoulders throw down and back, cascading down. Sending the heart forward to lead before our head. So pulling our head back a little bit and then tucking our chin in ever so slightly. And imagining a line of energy pulling us up from the floor. Grabbing the left wrist with the right hand, taking up and over to the right. Inhale, maybe the hands move towards the back of the room. Exhale, back to center, navel to spine to bring you up. Grabbing the left wrist with the right hand, taking up and then over. Maybe bring the hands towards the back of the room, inhale here. Exhale, navel to spine to bring you all the way back up. Letting the fingers gently trickle down, interlacing them behind your back. Really looping the shoulders as if you're pinching a pencil between your shoulder blades. At some point, our hands can come together. If you're not there, don't force it. Wherever you are, beginning to bend at the knees and slowly melting into a forward fold. Then your hands first travel up towards the sky and then in front of us. Letting the weight of our hands naturally guide us into this stretch. Assisting your body, breathing into the spaces that feel vulnerable. And eating it with your breath, letting it know it's okay. Continually scanning your body, continually relaxing anything that might be tense, that might be holding on to something, that might be doing work that is difficult. Beautiful. Slowly releasing the hands, releasing them all the way back down. Inhale, happens. Exhale, step it back. Vinyasa flow of choice. Our meat is down dog. Inhale, baby cobra up dog. Exhale. Inhale, the line breath. Bend the knees, stack the hips, so the knee continually moves toward the sky as our right foot continues on behind us. Making sure there's equal weight in both hands, releasing the neck here. Inhale, squaring the hips back again. Exhale, knee to chin. Inhale, lift up the back. Exhale, look forward, knee to right elbow. Inhale, back up. Exhale, knee to left elbow, forward. Inhale, back up. Exhale, step with your right. Wonderful. Pivoting the back foot, 45 degree angle. And when you're ready, coming up, warrior one. Again, maybe finding our tailbones kind of melting inward, so we're forming a straight line with our spine here. The Melting our shoulders down and back, maybe that expands the distance between our hands, and then trying to bring our hands together. And someone recently told me that yoga doesn't begin until we want to get out of a pose. So finding the static here, meeting the fear, and breathing with it. Finding beyond the point of which you want to break out of this pose and finding what is beyond that. So letting your body trust that it can withstand this, and maybe pulsating, inhaling, lifting through the crown, exhaling, lowering into that front leg. Inhaling, lifting through the crown, exhaling, deepening. Beautiful. One more inhale here. Exhale, melt it down. Pivoting our toes, we're going to come into kind of like a lunge. So we're going to be on our toes. Placing our left hand beside our right foot. Inhale, right hand up. Inhale, right hand a little bit higher to the front foot. Exhale, the right foot. Beautiful. Squeezing the thighs together. Inhale, back up. Listen carefully. Right hand lowers down to right hip. Inhale, left hand picking up and over. Maybe inhaling, bring the upper hand to the back of the room, and maybe letting the heart shine forward as we look up at the sky. Inhale here. Exhale. Lower the other hand. Inhaling our hands behind our back. Again, opening up our chest. And just think you're like the most confident peacock in all brands. Just really let that first shine forward. Maybe you can bring your hand outward. Whatever helps you just wiggle that chest, wiggle that tail feather. And exhaling slowly, coming all the way forward, hands move up towards the ceiling, then looking at the floor. Maybe resting some weight on your front thigh, maybe covering above. Find what support you need here. Inhale here. Exhale, relax your dog, relax your shoulders. Slowly lowering arms all the way down to the mat, placing the right arm towards the in front and outside of the right foot. So we're coming into half moon here. So maybe this is where we grab our block. We find it underneath our right hand. Our hips begin to stack up above one another. So maybe we bring our left hand to our left hip. Slowly opening it up. Our back foot is pressing into its heel, not to its toes, so as if it's pushing against the wall. And again, being gentle with yourself, remaining playful, meeting the steps like a 5-year-old, maybe lifting the leg all the way up. Maybe lifting the right hand from the ground into a chin mudra. Wherever you are, holding 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Half splits. Lifting, squaring the hips, lifting the left foot as high as possible. And melting it back down, meeting in the right leg. Beautiful. Forward fold. Let something go. So this time, crushing between our going up between our lips, fluttering lips, inhale, exhale, flutter. Shaking everything out. Releasing the hips. Beautiful. looking down at our feet. So if you can't see our toes, scoot those knees back. And tucking our tailbone under, so maybe that brings you up higher. I invite that. Coming into our heels, so maybe lifting our toes, and then spreading them wide and planting them back into the mat. Beautiful. Listen carefully, switching your weight into your right foot. Actually, no, let's switch up. Switch into the left foot. Lifting our right, crossing it over. Maybe this is our first variation, just placing it beside us on the floor. Maybe it tucks once, or maybe it tucks all the way around. Taking our right arm under our left. Again, maybe this crosses once, and maybe the palm feet. Eagle arms. Listen carefully. Inhale, lifting the hands all the way up towards the sky. Feel the stretch in your shoulders. Exhale, crunching all the way forward. Bring the navel towards the spine. Inhale, hands all the way up. Exhale, all the way forward. Two more of these. Inhale, stay with it. Exhale, forward. Inhale all the way up. And exhale, unwind everything forward. Bring our hands underneath our feet, letting our feet come all the way to our wrists as if they can massage them. Just again, let go of everything. Shake it out. Inhale for animal noise for size here. Releasing the hands. Inhale, half your lift. Exhale, step it back. You can take child's pose here, vinyasa flow, or knee in the dog. Meeting a down dog here in child's pose. Just gonna move through the other side. So now that we all know it, looks like it's gonna go a little bit faster. Notice the asymmetry. Notice how this side is different. And I invite you to embrace that difference. Inhale, left leg up towards the sky. Exhale, bending the knee, opening up the hips, stacking the hips. Inhale, exhale, push the right ear, soften your muscles, shoulders drop down the back. Inhale, square in the hips. Exhale, knee to chin. Inhale, back up. Exhale, knee to left elbow forward. Inhale, back up. Exhale, knee to right elbow forward. Inhale, back up. Exhale, step in here. Pivoting back foot 45 degree angle. Inhale, warrior one. Letting the tailbone sink. Letting the shoulders come down and back. Waiting for the body and the mind to want to break through this pose and letting yoga begin. Inhale, up through the crown. Exhale, lower into that front foot. Inhale, pulsating up. Exhaling, showing us the back edge of the back. There's a lot of storylines, a lot of fantasies that we create in our lives. Can we be with reality? Can we be with whatever is here, whatever is emerging? Five, four, three, two,
Pivoting the back toe to be on your toes, right hand on the mat, left hand distance.
One more time, inhale, and exhale, release everything.
your elbows, bring us further, open your elbows, pulling onto our toes. Inhale, sides. Every finger. So your hands melt wherever they are. Let our hands come back in front of us. Chin to chest, slowly stacking vertebra on top of vertebra, starting from the tailbone. Last little lift is the chin. Pushing, just letting the natural weight of the hands further guide our chin towards our chest. And release. Coming back up. Melting our right ear towards our right shoulder, just very gently. Back up. Again, melting it back down towards the right shoulder. Maybe again using just the weight of our right hand. Not pushing, but just placing the weight on top of our head. Inhale here. Exhale, soften. Releasing the right hand. Inhale, slowly back up. Thinking right ear toward between those two centers, so almost kind of like towards our right nipple. And inhale back up. Exhale, back down towards our right nipple and taking our hand, placing it lightly on our head. Making sure the shoulders are straight. And releasing the hand, bring our necks back up to center. And placing our left ear towards the left shoulder. Feeling a gentle stretch in our right neck. Back up. Exhale, lower back down, using our left hand just as a very light weight. Releasing left hand in back up. Exhale, left ear towards left head. Exhale.
down back here with the next leg. Using the left hand as a weight. And back down. Coming up onto our knees, tucking our toes under. Going over to the feet here. And maybe coming back up and taking a slight back bend, right? Facing our hands on our lower back, protect our lower back, tucking our tailbone. Gently bringing our shoulders down the back and looking up at the sky. If you would like to take full camel pose, you can gently let your hands be all the way down to your ankles. Two breaths here. Sending the mask aside, coming onto our bones. Taking the flesh out from under our feet. Inhale, hands up to the sky. And exhale, hold it forward. Inhale, forward. Exhale, release. Your hands out in front of us, continuing the control all the way down towards the left. Scooting our feet in and reaching our fingertips towards our feet, letting the tips of our fingertips graze the backs of our heels, and inhale from the edge. Releasing the hands underneath our bodies, moving the shoulders. Pushing into the feet, pushing out through the shins. Almost like as if you're squeezing a block between your knees, not letting your knees lay out too much. And taking three deep tummy breaths in. Releasing the hands, lifting onto the toes, and slowly melting each vertebra, starting from the upper spine onto the mat, all the way to the top. Crossing our right leg over our left, maybe interlacing our hands behind our left thigh, pulling our left side thigh towards us. All simultaneously pushing our right knee out from the front of the room. Pushing out through our feet through the heels, engaging our toes pulling back. Breathing into the right hip. Exhaling to the other leg. Inside. Exhale, right leg is behind. spreading your hands wide into a T shape or countless arms. Looking at a right hand and the other. Exhale, knees melt to the outside. Really appreciating these last few moments of breath. Feeling into the spaces of your body, the new spaces that you created. Getting over it. And then exhale, make the start of your knees back up. And bring them all the way over to the other side, shifting your gaze to the other end. Here. Exhale, make the spine breathe. And keeping any last touches maybe work in your intention. Settle, coming into the last mode, Shavasana, foot pose. Maybe go to the tailbone, and then using the tailbone, finding the arms to the back. Maybe pushing into the top of the head, I mean the back of the head, and the elbows, lifting the heart space, shimmying the shoulders underneath the heart space. And then maybe taking the chin in first, lengthening the neck and then slowly moving up to the back down. Moving the head. And exhaling all the muscle right there. Each exhale, feeling the support of your mind. Lift up to hold your body. With each exhale, softening your body. Surrendering each part. So you're melting on top of your mat. Shavasana, one of the most important poses in yoga. Ultimate breathing. Necessary for autonomy, integration, and respiration. Taking these next few moments and giving yourself permission to let go. Inhaling your fingers and your toes. Bringing your knees into the chest and let's come before rolling over to the right side. If you're using the right hand to come up, moving your knees. Taking a moment to connect the source, connect the essence. Using your left hand, guide you all the way up and then keep your eyes closed. And back up into the deep and constant pose. And to the long, clean hand up in the center. Bend down towards the stands. Keep up in front of your head. And finish on this one at last. Bring your attention to the second floor, moving across that point. Breathing into the legend. And setting your attention to the next practice out into the world. Thank you.